It all began when I was born a month too soon. My ma was frightened by a runaway saloon. Pa was forced to be a hobo because he played the oboe, and the oboe, it is clearly understood, is an ill wind that no one blows good. I'll never forget the morning that Grandpa ate the awning to impress a pretty lady who went for men that were shady. Then my Uncle Josiah lit the great Frisco fire, ran off to Hawaii with the old Erie cow, which his loving wife resented and thereupon invented a rolling pin that strikes and then says, pow. And I'm the result of the twisted eugenics of this family of inbred schizophrenics, the end of a long, long line of pets I design. Women's hats. I'm Anatole de Paris, I shriek with chic. My hat of the week, cause six divorces, three runaway horses. I'm Anatole de Paris, the hats I sell make husbands yell. Is that a hat or a two-room flat? Let me get my paw on a little piece of straw, and voila, a chapeau at $60 a throw. It's how I pull and chew one of the little things I do on it, like placing yards of lacing or a bicycle bill for two on it. The little ones, the big ones, the sat on by a pig ones, the foolish ones that perch and the ghoulish ones that lurch. The one called whiskey sour, designed for the cocktail hour. A little snip of potato chip and a trifle of the Eiffel Tower. I am Anatole of Paris, I must design. I'm just like wine, I go to your head. Give me thread and a needle, I itch, I twitch to stitch. I'm a glutton for cutting, for putting with a button to snip and plug, nip and tug, fix and trim, from the trim, tote bag, bag, hit the bay. And why do I sew each new chapeau with the style they must look positively grim in? Strictly between us, entre nous, I hate women.